All right. Hello. Hello. I turned up the mic a little bit, so hopefully I won't sound too quiet like I did in the last video. But today, since it's Christmas time, I'm going to be doing a little book haul. That's what the kids call it today. But first, let's get everything on the desk, shall we? You may be asking, Jeremy, you have a problem. And I would answer the words, yes. Yes, I do have a problem. Right around 50 books in total. But we're gonna go through them all. And I'm gonna tell you guys why I decided to get all these. Put them all back in the box or something. Something like that, I don't know. And then I'll drag it over again and we'll find a place to put them in the bookshelves. So, yeah. So, I don't know how I'm gonna color correct for the camera. I could just go back, I guess. Because if I go like this, then more light starts coming in. Wait a second, I'm gonna have to redo that because I'm gonna have to take off the sticker because I can't let you guys know where I work. Never Let Me Go by Kazuo Ishiguro. I'm mostly just doing this because he won the Nobel Prize in Literature last year for 2022, I believe. I got another one of his novels, and I believe that's the one for that they awarded it to. I don't know how they do. I think they do it for like his whole catalog of books. But next one, Tropic of Orange. I actually, when I got this transferred in, I completely forgot the fact that I did get it transferred in. So when I got it in, I was like, wait a second. Why? I don't know. I don't remember getting this. I don't know. I must have. Because I think it's magical realism, maybe? I don't know. Looks cool, though. I like the cover. So, Brain on Fire, My Month of Madness by Susanna Callahan. I think this one is about a girl's descent into madness. This is a nonfiction novel. She spent some time in a psych ward, and it just looked really interesting to me. To read about it, and so I was like, yeah, sure, why not, because I've done the same, so I would like to see her experience with it. The video is just going to be me peeling off stickers. These next four are very small. If you guessed it, they are plays by Shakespeare. We have, I feel like I'm doing this like Pokemon card style. King Lear, A Midsummer Night's Dream, Macbeth, and Richard III. I have, funnily enough, actually, I'll go show you guys. I have this beautiful, beautiful edition of The Tempest by Shakespeare that I bought for class a couple years ago. It is very easily my favorite. Honestly, this might be some like my most favorite artwork for a book in general. Like, dude, look at that. Sorry about the car driving by. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? You guys can't see the blue all that well, but I think it's frankly beautiful. So yeah, so I just decided to get some Shakespeare. Why not? I mean, might as well. It wasn't too expensive. Next I have this beautiful cover of Moby Dick. I think it's really nice. Actually, I almost picked up a second copy of Moby Dick because I forgot that I put this one in my bin. So super beautiful copy. I've never read it before. But here's to hoping that I will get a chance to read it soon enough. This next one is a repeat novel. I've read it before, but because he is my favorite living author and I would love to collect all of his watercolor editions. This is Neil Gaiman's American Gods. We got this in and I just had to have it because I love his watercolor editions. I've got a couple other ones resting on my bookshelf just because they're so beautiful. Next, moving on to postmodern authors, one who's rather complicated, but who is nonetheless a very, very well-respected author because, I mean, he, you know, changed the game. Infinite Jest by David Foster Wallace. Sorry, I'm chewing gum right now. Apparently, this is his masterpiece, and it's like 1,000 pages. A little bit over. So, that'll be fun to read. Not, it will, but it's just, I'm gonna have to read something like in between reading it, because that's a no-go for just reading that by itself. I feel like I'd go insane unless I really love postmodernism, but modernism is where my heart's at, you know, Mrs. Dalloway and the Metamorphosis. I've been watching Benjamin McAvoy, I don't know how to say his last name, on YouTube. Thomas Hardy is apparently one of his favorite authors ever. And I was like, yeah, you know, I'll just grab it. Far From the Madding Crowd is, I guess, one of his best works. So I was like, yeah, why not? You know, I'll just grab it. It's whatever. See how the Brit does. He's excellent. If you want to like really get into like deep classical literature and like take his reviews, and he's got a Patreon, which I'll probably sign up for once I'm done with my master's program. I think that'll be a lot of fun, or maybe I'll even do it beforehand, just to like really get some nice reading in, nice, deep, sophisticated, layered, get a lot of practice with looking at everything with a very critical and analytical eye. Next is probably one of my favorite authors prose-wise. I've actually got another one of his novels that I've read before in the stack somewhere. It's right here. It's beautiful. I didn't have to read this one for college, but I did have to read the other one in my stack. This is Mary by Vladimir Nabokov. I don't know what it's about, but all I know, if it's Nabokov, it's going to be good. So, once again, with a returning author, we have Neil Gaiman's The Graveyard Book. This is also a repeat novel because I have his right there. Right there on my bookshelf, so. Not bad. This one, obviously, a very, very classic modernist novel about the African American in America, Invisible Man, by Ralph Ellison. I asked one of my coworkers. She said that it was okay. You know, like it was good. I'm sure it was revolutionary for its time. But I'm still excited to read it. Just because of everything that I've heard about and just how far it pushed the post-colonial lit crit theory and feminist theories forward, and the neo-colonialist post-lit theory. Sorry, I'm starting my master's program soon. I got accepted into my master's program. I'm just really gonna have to get into the mindset of reading and stuff like that, so that'll be it's gonna be a lot of fun. It's gonna be a lot of work, though. I'm pretty nervous about it, because my writing has never been very formal. It's never been very academically worded. So I write how I speak a lot of the time, which is very informal. So that's okay. Hey, we'll get there. We'll get there. Junior Diaz is Drown. I had to read this one. This is a short story collection for school as well. It was amazing. Junior Diaz, he's from Puerto Rico, and I had to read this one for school, and it was excellent, excellent. I believe I reviewed The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde on this channel, but I did read that one recently, and it was very good. His prose is also very nice, very fluent. Just you really get a sense for all these really shitty characters But you can't help but feel bad for them sometimes, just because of the way he's able to make you latch on to them. Next one, I've heard a lot of good things about Hyperion by Dan Simmons. Obviously, really classic sci-fi novel. And I just really love this cover. I think that's just such a cool cover. So, seriously, look at that. That's so cool. Next one, I've heard a lot about that it's very sad. This is a contemporary novel. I got shit on at work recently because my coworkers were like, "Do you read anything contemporary, Jerem?" And I was like, "I do actually." And then I only named off like two novels that I've read, but I read Neil Gaiman and I read Chimamanda and I'm sure I'll read Eleanor Oliphant is completely fine. Obviously, I've heard that this is a very sad book, and so I am ready to, brother Sky, please, you're so cloudy right now. Why are you doing this to me? I'm excited to read this one. I heard that this one was a very good novel, just because how sad it is, and you're not expecting it to be sad, but it's got a very good premise, apparently, very original storytelling from what I've heard. So, this one is a classic. I actually never read this in school, high school, middle school, or anything like that. This is Life of Pi. I just thought I'd always, I should probably get a chance to read it. Because if I want to be a teacher, I should probably read most of like the classics. I don't like early American lit. It's so boring. It's so dry. I barely even like early British lit as well. The only thing I like from there was Moll Flanders was okay. I liked The Monk, as disturbing as it was. Okinawa? No. Wow, that makes me really upset that I can't remember. It's a short one. That one's really brutal as well. Gulliver's Travels. I quite enjoyed. Repeat author, once again, Vladimir Nabokov. This is not the one that I had to read for class, but this is a King, Queen, Knave. Look at that cover. Cover is beautiful. Again, I don't know what that one's about. I'm pretty sure that one's also like short story collection. This one. We just got this one in. I'm pretty sure these are like essays from a college professor, but you guys are gonna see the cover and you're gonna be like, "Jerem, that book is cursed. It is cursed. Should never have been allowed to be published. Who the hell made this?" This is Techno-Capitalist Feudalism by Michel Luc Bellemare, or Michel Luc Bellemare. Techno-Capitalist Feudalism. The Political Economy of Scientific Anarchist Communism. I just bought it because my best friend is a poli-sci major, going into law, and this just looked really interesting, and I thought I should have it. And also, look at the font that they used. It's like typewriter font almost. It's like something you'd see in like not this. I don't know why they chose this. I'll probably never read this. This will not be read. Well, I chose it because I needed to have this. Probably never gonna have it again. So, Stephen King by Fairy Tale. Fairy Tale by Stephen King. It's just a kid and his dog going on an adventure. Less scary, I've heard. So, still really big though. I don't know how he writes so much. Wanted to get some of the classics. By classics, I mean classics. The Aeneid by Virgil, translated by Robert Fagles. I've heard this translation is pretty good. And also, I just really, really like that cover. Like that looks like a really nice cover. I don't know what the Aeneid is about, but Virgil led Dante down into hell and back out. He was considered the master way back when. So, oh yeah, I also bought Dante's. Oh yeah, I guess I should go get those ones too. They weren't part of this haul, but they are still very new. And I can introduce them really quick. Oh, and I guess I should introduce the ones that I got for Christmas as well. I also got a $50 gift card to Barnes & Noble, which was super cool. So for Christmas, I got two Murakami novels. I got Kafka on the Shore, which I've been meaning to get for a very long time. And I got Sputnik Sweetheart, also by Murakami. I got these from my uncle, so thank you very much. I appreciate them. I can't wait to read them. It's going to be great. I bought this one at the... What is this? Oh, yeah. I bought this one at the airport. Paul Harding won the Pulitzer Prize and was shortlisted for the Booker Prize, This Other Eden. I'm waiting to get Paul Lynch's Prophet Song and I think it's Paul Murray's the Bee Sting or something like that. They were like 1 and 2 for the Booker Prize. So I'm excited to read those. I don't have them, but I'll get them eventually. And this one, another one of my best friends sent it to me for Christmas, The Myth of Sisyphus by Albert Camus. I've got, I think, The Plague by Albert Camus back there somewhere. So that'll be nice and fun as well. I can't wait to read this. Albert Camus' prose and his philosophy is just fascinating to read. And the last one, Dante's Divine Comedy, Inferno, Purgatorio, and Paradiso, all translated by John Ciardi. I've heard that this is actually a very, very nice translation because John Ciardi actually speaks Italian, and he really kept like the flowy, poetically prose of Dante, but still adhering to like academically like trustworthy translation. So next one, I had to read for one of my philosophy classes, and I don't know where my copy went. I don't know if I ever had my copy or not. Phaedrus by Plato. This one was pretty good. Still super deep. I don't know if I did a good paper on this one or not. I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure I did a good paper on this one. Next is one that I probably should have read as an undergrad with a minor in philosophy. I never got around to it. The Republic by Plato. I know it's like a very important work, and yeah, I had to read other stuff, but it's just good to have it. It's very important, I know, for a lot of different philosophical inquiries, but this is Walt Whitman's collected collection of poetry and prose. I actually got this because, like I said, Benjamin McEvoy, if that's how you say his last name, does something akin to like a reading club every year where he goes through certain classics throughout the year. And I believe Walt Whitman was slated for fall, if not spring. I have, this is also a repeat edition, or copy rather, but this is John Steinbeck's The Grapes of Wrath. I have another copy, but it is falling apart, and it's smaller too, so the font isn't nearly as cramped as in this one as it is in the other one, which will be really nice. Okay, we're going to be getting into some philosophy books, because they were all getting clearanced, and I was like, why not? Might as well just take them. Beyond Good and Evil by Friedrich Nietzsche. Nothing to say there. Just solid philosophy that everybody should read. I'm hoping that I'll be able to get some lit crit stuff to read to enhance my own writing. This is Michel Foucault's The History of Sexuality, Volume 1. I mean, Foucault is a excellent philosopher / literary theorist. He really pushed our understanding of certain aspects of society forward in many ways that I can't tell you right now. But I have had to study him. Oh yeah, I also got these two right here. One is actually a textbook that I had to use for my Intro to Lit Theory class. It was probably my favorite textbook, and it is one that I'm going to continuously look forward to and use, hopefully, all throughout my life. It is the Norton Anthology of Theory and Criticism. It is super important if you want to be a good academic writer. It covers everything. I'm pretty sure it covers everything. And then next to it is Edward Said's Orientalism and Imperialism, which of course is also very, very important. But this is Critical Essays by Jean-Paul Sartre. I think we did his Meditations, I believe, which I hope I have somewhere. I don't know. This is an advanced reader's copy. So, How to Say Babylon by Sophia Sinclair. I don't know. I've never had an advanced reader's copy before. This is basically, publishers will send this to you. These are like unedited novels, and you can send in your reviews of it and any changes that you saw, any editorial mistakes that you caught. And yeah, these are mostly for like book reviewers and stuff before they go out. So super cool to have. Super cool to have. These stacks are getting rather precarious, but that's okay. Return of the Sea Otter. I like it. I love sea otters. Sea otters are native to the West Coast, specifically like Northern California and like Washington. I got to see a couple when I went to Seattle last time. It was super nice. I think the writing's good so far. I started it on my lunch break a couple weeks ago. Just super cool otter facts. Did you know that otters have, on average, 1 million hairs per square inch? That's why they don't die of hypothermia in the water in the wintertime, because they literally, the hair is so dense that it creates bubbles and they can just float on the water. That's how they float on the water. It's insane. Next one. Oh yeah, so recently I got the art section for my store. So I'm in charge of like all things art and stuff. And of course, you guys know how bad I am with money. So I was like, you know what? Let's get some art books. Let's delve into some other fields. Why not? Courbet? I believe that's how you say his name. I don't know. There's something that I just really like about like some types of artists. They just do stuff really well. Oh yeah, I think it was this one. Look at that. Look at that. Simply fantastic. Here's another one from my art section. I believe that this is probably my favorite artist, which I guess would mean that I am an impressionist. Monet. I think his artwork is just fantastic. The impressionist period is just so beautiful to me. It is so beautiful, so gorgeous. I just there there's just something about the way that they're portraying our world with these brush strokes. I don't know. I just find it fascinating. What's this one? Oh yeah. I saw that we got this one in, and it's like a nonfiction novel. It's a bibliophile. So it just like I look through it and I'm pretty sure it just goes over like different types of books that it would recommend to you depending on what you like. And it's recent too. It's recent. I know it's recent because I saw that this has Exit West, and Exit West was a very, very good novel. And I actually recommended it to a coworker yesterday, and I really hope she reads it because it's really good. But yeah, so hopefully this will give me some recommendations, and it's just, it's just a nice book to have. Why not? Almost there, I think. Another Michel Foucault. Discipline and Punish. It's funny because there's a ruler there. I've definitely been hit with a ruler before. I think this has his. Yep. This has his Panopticon. Friedrich Nietzsche. Once again, thus spakes Zarathustra. Classic American writer. I've only read one of his novels so far. The Sun Also Rises by Ernest Hemingway. I think this one my friend has recommended to me the most. I think. No, I must have The Old Man and the Sea somewhere.
Oh, wait. Wait, is it that one? Is it that one? Or is that How to Lose the Title? Oh, yeah, that is. Okay. Oh, yeah, I also bought others. I've done two, like, small book hauls before, but
I didn't want to grab everything because I thought that would just be a little annoying. But, yeah, I've got that one as well. This one I had to read for class, and I fell in love with Vladimir Nabokov. Pinyin follows a Russian professor in America trying to teach Russian, I believe, or trying to teach English. I can't remember which one. Just a super sweet novel. It's like, if you want to read like a day in the life of this, is just there. I don't know how Nabokov does it, but he just does. He just does. In every way, he just does. Once again, Kazuo Ishiguro, Clara and the Sun. Clara and the Sun. Sci-fi novel. Heard it was really good. Won the Nobel Prize. Wanted to check it out because I was like, why not? This is How You Lose Her by Junior Diaz. I don't know anything about this one. I know that he's obviously wrote other good stuff because I've had the pleasure of reading it. And I wonder how similar this will be to my predicament. So, had a breakout period in the last 10 or so years. This is a super white novel. White Teeth by Zadie Smith. There we go. I think you start with this one. I think this was her first one, and people really loved it. They said characters are super deep, super intricate. Novels, plots are super deep. Prose is okay for the most part. Super just fresh, I guess. Apparently, like, the characters don't all have that much progression, or if they do, they're very gridlocked into that, like, character progression. No, this isn't a video game, Jerm. Character development. They are apparently very stuck in their ways, a lot of the characters, and you can tell that they sort of agree with Zadie Smith on a lot of things. Another one. Come on. And turn. There we go. Zadie Smith on Beauty. Nice. It took me until the end of the video to figure out how to do this, to get everything to be shown. Same thing. Just wanted to read it, just to have another one of her novels. Just trust the internet for the most part. This one I'm excited to read. The Reigns of the Day by Kazuo Ishiguro. Again, this is the one apparently for the year that they awarded him the Nobel Prize. So it's about a British butler going over his life and the family that he's served for the past umpteen years. I read her sister's works, and I didn't like it as much as I thought I should have the first time around. I'll have to revisit it, because I think it definitely deserves another try. Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre. And obviously the one I was talking about was Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte. I'll have to definitely go back to Wuthering Heights eventually, because I definitely think it deserves the love that a lot of people have for it. But I'm excited to read Jane Eyre as well. One of my favorite modernist authors, Orlando by Virginia Woolf. Oh, okay. So, that's right. It's about a fictitious character. It's a biography about a fictitious character, Orlando. So, super excited to read it because, Virginia Woolf has some of the most beautiful and mind-bending prose you can imagine. I got to show you this one.
I got two copies of The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath, one of which I will never read, and the other, which I will definitely read. This is the one that I will not read, because it is still sealed. It's an Easton Press edition. So, boom, The Bell Jar. Absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. So, Olivia Blake, she wrote Alone With You in the Ether. Self-published it. Come on, camera. Pick it up. There we go. Alone With You in the Ether. This is her self-published copy. And it got picked up by a by a traditional publisher, and obviously she stopped making these. So these are worth a bit of money now, not too much. I think anywhere from like $60 to $100, but this one's a little roughed up. That's okay. But yeah, I got that for super cheap. We only had one left in our entire system, so that was really cool.
Yeah. So, where was I? Leo Tolstoy's The Death of Ivan Ilyich. I didn't realize that this was a short story. So, because I have War and Peace. Sorry, I have Anna Karenina right there. Pretty afraid to read it. Just because of how big it is. That's why I'm reading The Idiot by Dostoevsky right now. I read 150 pages like 2 days ago, and I feel like I barely made a dent in it. But still, I love Dostoevsky, and you guys will definitely hear that when I do the next video for him. Speaking about authors I love, this author wrote probably my favorite novel of all time. Gabriel Garcia Marquez, Love in the Time of Cholera. Cholera, Jesus. Obviously, he did 100 Years of Solitude. And I did a video of that on this channel. I know I did. If he wrote that, then I'm excited to read this one. I don't know how well it'll stand up to 100 Years of Solitude. But, you know, if it even hits, like, half of that, it'll be an incredible novel. This one was just a distribution item that we got, and I just really love the cover. I doubt you guys will be able to see it all that much because my camera's being dumb. I'm gonna get a ring light and I'm just gonna put it there, and I'm gonna close the curtains next time, and we're just gonna see how that goes. The sea is not made of water. It's such a gorgeous cover. I love it so much. There we go. Yeah, that's not too bad. It's just a shrimp. I'm pretty sure this is a nonfiction novel. We are done after this last one. I think I got this philosophy one just because I think a friend was working on it or something. Spinoza of the Improvement, On the Improvement of the Understanding, The Ethics Correspondence. Something good to have. some good philosophy to have. So, yeah. Should I have just closed it this whole time? Is that what I should have done? I guess that's what I should have done. So, figured that out in the last, like, 5 minutes of the video. That's okay. We learn, we grow. So, now, you guys are going to be with me, and I will cut out stuff, or maybe I'll just speed it up. Trying to fit these all onto my bookshelf. It's not gonna go great because I do not have the room anymore. If I want to stay in center frame, or at least like midway, and I put the books up there, you guys won't be able to see them. Yeah, is that bending the top? It is bending the top. Oh, you are kidding me. You're kidding me.
Absolutely.
Oh yeah, you can. Where is it? There. Oh. there, there, there. You can see, you can still see some books up there. So. Okay, cool. Mission accomplished. I will, an hour and 10 minutes. I don't want to go through that footage. Oh, well. All right. It's only 1:45 right now. I can do it. All right, everybody. I will see you later.